fair question to ask, considering that the same team that made the crazy WarioWare series is also behind this game. Right, so Rhythm Heaven Fever is based around short music games where you control a single element, such as a dancing lobster or a high-fiving clock-riding monkey. You need to time your actions, such as high-fiving, so that matches the music's beat. Thankfully, the game provides visual clues to help you with your timing. For example, in Double Date, you can rely almost entirely on the visual cues determining when to kick the ball away. However, the game will also purposely screw with you every now and then by obscuring the visuals, forcing you to rely on rhythm alone. Yes, Rhythm Heaven Fever can be a cruel adventure, but there's very little room for error, so you might have to replay a specific game quite a few times before passing it. Fortunately, the game is simplified in control, since the DES version is relegating everything to just two buttons, A and B. While most actions are performed with just the A button, like shaking a tambourine, you also need to pinch both at the same time to perform alternative actions, such as smacking the tambourine. Thankfully, every game features a brief tutorial that gets you up to speed, even though I found a few of them, like Donk Donks, to be pretty useless. Now, Rhythm Heaven Fever is built around about 50 of these games, broken up into sets of 5. 4 of them are individual stages, while the 5th is always a remix stage that combines elements of the previous 4 into a brand new song, requiring you switching your gameplay on the fly. This is actually a pretty cool way of breaking up the game, as the remix stages rely entirely upon the skills you've learned up to that point. There is one drawback, though. Because you unlock the level sequentially, getting stuck on just one holds your entire game's progress. This can be extremely frustrating, because if you get stuck on a specific challenge, there is nothing else for you to do until you get past it. It would have been better if you unlocked the games in sets of 4, allowing you to hop between them as you wish. Mercifully, the game will eventually offer you the chance to skip a game entirely if you're truly stuck, but I always feel like this is a little bit of a cop-out that could have been prevented with a more open structure. Now, what largely makes Rhythm Heaven so unique are the totally off-the-wall scenarios that the developers came up with for each game.
Besides the sniper rifles. And they work really well. So these are basically just the yeah, class 1. You want to have stopping power as well, so you can get that one-shot kill without having hit markers and stuff. And you can have one sniper class. I chose the R700. And instead of putting stopping power, I put double taps, since I mean, it's pretty much guaranteed you're going to get a good shot and one-shot kill on people. And gave it a special sidearm, the USP45 with silencer. Those are basically all the perks and weapons you need. Just copy those over to the enemy side, and it'll be on both sides. And that's really about it. So once you do that, I'm going to press the back button, which is the new button. I'm not pretty sure that's called. Then you'll just save it. I've saved a couple of them, but this one works the best. I like this one the most. And so, yeah, now I'm going to switch to gameplay. Okay, so here we are in the game. I have chosen the M14 as my primary, with the M9 as a secondary. This should be a pretty good class. Probably my favorite one, because the iron sights are really good, and you can pretty much scope out anybody and find them. I have the M9 as a secondary, and also keep in mind that you have friendly fire on, so you don't want to shoot your teammates on accident. And just like that. Yeah, you can drop people just very, very quickly. I mean, you just look at somebody and then, like, hit them. Pretty much how it goes. I mean, at least the bots are easy, but if you play this with a couple of buddies or so, you don't have at least, like,
Jax.
No, you didn't. What the fuck, man?
Hey, Jax.
Holy Francis. You have 50 rounds. And it's not like these bands were prepared. It's not like the last deadly is really advanced worker. You have a reload. This you don't have a reload. You have to wait for it to regen over time. Okay, it's tricky. And the MP still.
Oh my god, dude.
Yo, there was a feed opportunity, but this thing ran out of ammo.
Oh, I got killed. Alright, let's see how this sounds. Looks. That sounds okay.
Look how off my
hand. This guy's name is KDM.
I was about to fuck. Yeah, I'm good. Turning from my bomb, man. I can't do the special thing, but I can do this.
Oh my god.
Checking stuff out of it. I don't know if I'm gonna do any breakfast thing here. I'm not sure yet. Okay. I'll let you know. I'm gonna get her dressed first. and then get some stuff situated, and then I'm gonna get washed up and dressed, and then I'm not sure how much time I have by then. But I'll let you know. I just felt like sleeping a little longer because I'm like, it's Monday, and I just have to go back to work the first day, so I want to take a break.
Wow, that was a great vacation, man.
This backlot looks so different to the NW backlot.
Left. Yeah, that's true. It didn't look on fire at all. I didn't think about that. More gasoline? Yeah, more gasoline.
That's enough gas.
Soda cans very far, but also tennis balls fit in it. So Rob here has a fire it, and it lights that gunpowder and pushes flaming powder out of this barrel, launching a soda can or whatever is in your barrel. So my hopes are we'll shoot the tennis ball out with that flaming powder. It'll light our gasoline-soaked tennis ball and shoot a flaming tennis ball. Now we're in Texas, which is a nice spot to shoot into. We don't start any forest fires. Only we can prevent those.
This is going to be our target. It's a castle that we as dragons are attacking, and we're going to fill a Tupperware full of gunpowder. This is a really good idea. And we're going to put it out in the middle of this little pond.
Team deathmatch.
Try to shoot flaming balls at it.
Is that too loud?
No.
It's not loud.
Let's do this, Marines. We've taken the lead.
See, my logic is just really applied to me, too.
I don't really hear anything.
Try again.